Auschwitz. We're now going to hear from another Holocaust survivor, Mrs. Orden, who's going to join us here at the podium.
Imagine our streets existed and we were, of course, separated. My mother was a young woman and she stayed with me. I was with her the whole year. I worked in our streets and she did too. Till January 18, when they had to clean out our streets, and we took that death march from our streets to Germany, which was a horrible time because it was winter and cold and no food and no water. And at that time my mother was already, had been in the hospital already. We had to carry her, but we arrived to a camp and where it was Ravensbrück, which was horrifying because it was full, infested with lies. And we were there for a while, just sitting on the floor, not moving, just sitting and killing lies, and then moved to another lager. Horrible condition. My mother's condition deteriorating. We have fed green, rotten bread because there was no food anymore. And we just didn't know if we lived, we died, what would happen. And then one day, May 2nd, an American tank arrives. And I didn't say my dear father was cremated with my grandma and the rest of the family, and they arrived to our streets. And we survived, we were freed 8 seconds. But my mother died May 9th. There, liberated, she was in such bad condition. And I left her in Germany. And I'm here, imagine. I could survive, I could retreat from there, going back to my hometown. Fortunately, my brother was still alive. And I lived with him for a while. Shut in a room and crying day and night, great night, for weeks, doing nothing else, just crying and looking at my mother's picture. And then one day, a friend who I met in Auschwitz came to my town with her boyfriend and another couple, a young man. He had a beautiful carriage with horses. There were no cars. And that young man had a girlfriend, and I was invited to that lunch also. Must have been like 2-3 months after I got home. And that young man gets up on the table and comes over to me and asks me to marry him. And I never saw him, I never knew him before. And I was just stunned. I had the little boyfriend too by then. And we have been married 69 years. And we created a beautiful life, a lovely family. And I feel lucky and fortunate having the piano always naturally. But I feel fortunate and lucky to have survived. And I try to teach everybody and tell everybody the importance of not giving up. Just always have hope. Good things come also after the bad ones. And we are Israel, loving, and living a Jewish life, and all our family is Jewish, and I turned to my father in the temple, and I tell him, he must be so happy to see me as a Jewish woman, and with all my Jewish family. It carried on what he would like to see us, and of course my mother. And that's my life story.
Every Jew who came to concentration camp didn't have a name, they had a number. And that number was tattooed onto their arm. And that's how they were known. They became a number, dehumanized. It was part of the Nazi dehumanizing process. But all survivors carry that number with great pride.
As you know,